right, we're back with more of the American Music Awards, and to present the award for favorite country new artist, here's the woman who won it last year, and she's still just as fine as she was last year. Give it up for my girl, Shania Twain.
Thank you so much. I was honored to win this award last year, and I know it will mean a lot to the artist who takes it home tonight. Garth Brooks told us earlier that it was the year of the woman. I'm proud to say that all three nominees for Favorite Country New Artist are women. Take a look. Changes, Lord,
sort of the favorite heavy metal hard rock artist, Metallica.
Oh, I'm in the mood.
All right, then, what? Good, yes. Heavy metal still lives.
Hello.
Who has the final input in
your... Bob Rock.
Final production? Everybody, these four people right in here.
That's us. That would be us.
Have you guys heard Taproot?
We heard it last night, and it is totally amazing.
There's been a lot of interpretations of our music by a lot of different people in the last years, and this is definitely one of the coolest. Yeah. Really, really cool.
Plus, he's a good guy to hang with.
As well as one of the most surprising people.
He took us out and showed us the dark, seedy side of L.A. yesterday. It was great.
My head hurts.
Oh, God. Fat Boone.
We got matching tattoos.
Can you tell us a little bit about how it feels to take this award, seeing as how long you guys have been making music, and music is changing so much?
I think it's really cool that we're still considered relevant. I mean, it's been 15 years, and there's been so many changes around us. I think within the band, it's still very, very strong, and it's just great. This is voted for by the fans, and you know, we got snubbed at the Grammys, and it's great that we're here and winning, and by the people that really matter.
Are you pissed off the guests about getting snubbed at the Grammys?
This is much more fun.
Yeah, this is a lot better.
Loser.
Yeah. James, why did you go ballistic when Jason did a solo project, but then you did this Corrosion of Conformity single?
Ooh. I can do what I want. He can't. No. I didn't do that thing. You're not supposed to know.
You're looking at four Pat Boones right here.
Let me confirm that for you.
Four Pat Boones right here.
That was definitely not a solo thing.
It was totally different.
Backups
totally different
for some buddies.
How has the tour been going, and compare it to the Lollapalooza experience?
It's a lot better and a lot funner and a lot louder and a lot better. Did I say that? It's a lot better?
Not as many people.
On stage.
Not as many people on stage.
We have control, you know, complete control of everything, and our crew runs everything. It makes it better. It makes it for a better show for everybody across the organization.
And we get to go to places like Ames, Iowa.
True.
Tomorrow
morning.
9 o'clock in the morning.
Yeah.
You have dates for it.
Yes, I did. I got married, and not to any of these three guys. Mm-hmm. And
how long have you known her?
2 days.
A year.
Was she cute?
Spending your honeymoon with us?
No, with three guys. With unfortunately, I can never win, no matter what I do.
Well, you won tonight, though.
Married to metal.
They see the purity in what we do, and that we really give a shit, and it's not just trying to hang on to something.
Yeah, our music definitely has stood the test of time. 15 years is 15 years, and like you know, our early stuff sounds as fresh as it did back then. I mean, to me, it does.
Is it tough to come back when you get back on stage and do that 15-year-old stuff to make it fresh?
Nah, we change it around a lot and screw it up and just do whatever we have to do to make it, you know, still fun.
I prefer Motley Crue, the old singer or the new singer?
I prefer them when they actually play instruments and stuff, actually.
What, dat tape or no dat tape?
Rather than miming everything.
Wow.
We're staying out till the end of May, North America. And then we are going to finish part two of the Load album, which is probably about halfway done, and we just got to do the overdubs, and it should be out, knock on wood, by Thanksgiving.
Because you guys have been making music for so long, and staying in the limelight for so long, who were your influences when you guys were deciding to rock
the industry?
Julius Caesar.
That's how old we are.
Black Sabbath is the answer to that question.
We'll probably hit the road again early next year, and we won't be here in the States. It's going to start somewhere in the Far East.
There's some places that we haven't been for 4 or 5. There's some places we haven't been for 4 or 5 years. South America, Australia, Pacific Rim, Japan, that kind of thing. We'll be touring on 2 new albums. Correct. That's what Lars is saying. We're finishing up that, release it for Christmas, and then tour those places we haven't been on this round.
Billy Joel says that any guy who gets into rock and roll does it to get girls. Did you guys do it for that reason?
I did it to get free guitars.
Where are they?